fifth and the last form of a business organization that we are going to discuss here is joint stock company. How do we define joint stock company? It can be defined as an artificial person created by law having a separate legal entity, perpetual succession, and a common seal. Now, the definition itself is, you know, it explains the different features and characteristics of a joint stock company. Number one, it is an artificial person. Artificial person means it has an entity, it has an existence of its own, but it is not like a natural person. You can't see it, you can't touch it, you can't feel it, right? But it exists. It is an artificial person as it is a creation of law. Artificial person created by law having a separate legal entity, meaning the business organization company is separate from the owners. Company is separate from its owners. There is a distinction between owners and ownership and the management. Then perpetual succession. Perpetual succession meaning it continues to exist year after year. The death, lunacy, etc. of the members of the company or the owners of the company, that is the shareholder, it does not affect the existence of the company. It still continues to exist. And a common seal. Since it is an artificial person capable of entering into contracts, signing contracts, capable of suing people, being sued by people, right? But because it is an artificial person, it does not have, it cannot sign contracts on its own, right? So the official signature of the company in the form of a stamp, right? That is called as a common seal. So I hope now the definition of company will become clear to you. It can be defined as an artificial person, right? Created by law, having a separate legal entity, perpetual succession, and common seal. What are the features of company? Number one, separate legal entity. Maine bola tha, separate legal entity and limited liability, theek hai? And continued existence. Ye tino kab aa jate hai features? When it is compulsory for a business organization, for any particular form of business organization to get itself registered under any particular act. Here, company is also compulsorily required to be registered under Companies Act 2013. So, jaise hi uska registration compulsory hua, theek hai, compulsory hai iska registration, to teen features automatically aa jayenge: separate legal entity, limited liability, and continued existence. Separate legal entity, that means the business, the company has an entity separate from that of its owners. It is considered as a separate person from the owners, right? It is an artificial person. It is not like a natural person which can be seen, touched, and felt. It is an artificial person created by law, which is capable of entering into contracts, signing deals, okay, suing people, and be sued by people. Clear? Then formation. It is formed as per the provisions of the Companies Act 2013. Whatever legal formalities are required to be performed under the Act, they have to be necessarily performed. Then perpetual succession, that is the company continues to exist despite the death, lunacy, or bankruptcy of any of its members, right? Then control and ownership. Now the ownership of the company, it lies with the shareholders, right? The ownership of the company lies with the shareholders, right? But the control of the company lies with the management. The control of the company lies with the management. That means, what does it mean? That our shareholders kaun hote? Basically, how does a company get the money? Okay? I think if you've seen that movie Guru, right? There the concept of the company has been beautifully described, right? Wherein this guy Abhishek, he tells people that apna paisa meri company, apna paisa lagao aur malik ban jao. What does that mean? That you contribute. There are huge number of people all over the world, right? We ask them, even if one person, even if each person contributes about 1,000 rupees, can you imagine the amount of financial pool that I'm going to be creating, right? Although each person's contribution is quite small, and if he was to invest that money himself in one of his own ventures, that would not mean anything. That would not mean anything, right? But if I invest 1,000 rupees in a company wherein there are millions of people investing in that company, so there's going to be a huge pool of financial resource that is going to be created for that company. And that capital of the company is divided into equal units called as shares, right? And the shareholders are nothing else but they are the owners of the company. So there is not one owner of the company, there are millions and zillions of the owners of the company, right? But because the owners of the company are spread over a wide geographical area, what they do is they select their representatives. They select their representatives in the form of board of directors, right? They select their representatives, right? Then their representatives, that is in terms of the directors, okay? They are the ones who take the major decisions for the company. It is not the owners who take the decisions for the companies, but it is the board of directors who take the decisions for the managing the affairs of the company, right? So when we talk about control and ownership, ownership lies with the shareholders, okay? Ownership is going to lie with the shareholders, but it is managed. Who's going to manage the organization? It is going to be managed by the board of directors. Then comes limited liability. I told you, when an organization is registered under any particular act, the liability of its members is going to be limited to the amount of capital that they have contributed. Agar maine 1000 rupees lagaye company mein, to mere dubenge bhi 1000 rupees sirf. That's it. Not more than that. My personal assets are not going to be involved. Then I explained common seal. Because company is an artificial person, it cannot sign contracts on its own. So therefore, there is a stamp, right, which acts as the official signature of the company. That is called as a common seal. Jab tak company ke documents pe wo common seal nahi hogi, it will not considered as legal. Then risk bearing. Yahan pe risk bearing is relatively less. Why? Because the risk is spread, okay, amongst all the shareholders. Risk is spread amongst all the shareholders. So therefore, the risk to be borne by every single shareholder is relatively less. Last is transferability of the shares. Shares can easily be transferred in the name of anyone else, right? So it is not a problem if I have invested my money in a company and tomorrow if I need money, I can always sell my shares, okay, on the stock exchange. They can easily be transferred in someone else's names. Now coming to the merits of joint stock company, limited liability will be a merit, right? Because the liability of the members is limited to the amount of capital contributed by them. Transfer of shares. Shares can easily be transferred in the name of anyone else. They can easily be traded on the stock exchange. Perpetual succession, that is the death and lunacy of the partner members of a company, that is the shareholders, will not affect the continuity of the company. There is a case which will often be asked in your question papers, that there was a board meeting going on and there was a bomb blast, right? There was a bomb blast. All the members of the company, the board of the directors and whosoever shareholders and all were present, they died in the bomb blast. But the company, will the company still continue to exist or no? The answer is yes, the company will continue to exist. Why? Because company has an entity separate from that of its owner. So even if all the owners have died, the company will still continue to exist. There's a lot of scope for expansion, because when they have huge pool of financial resources, they can invest their money in many other lucrative options. There's a lot of scope for expansion and growth. Professional management, because they have a huge pool of financial resources, they can employ professionals to take care of different aspects of management, right? Like your human resources, for planning your finance, for planning your marketing, you can hire experts, because now there is no shortage of money. Coming to the demerits, it's a complex procedure, right? To register a company, to start a company, it's quite a complex procedure, because a lot of legal formalities are involved for registration of a company under Companies Act 2013. Then there is absence of secrecy, because the Companies Act 2013 requires a company to publish its accounts, right? It is the responsibility of the company to publish an annual report and send it across to the shareholders, right, on annual basis. Then there is impersonal work environment. Now, since there is a separation of ownership from management, there is a separation of ownership from management. Owners kaun hai? Shareholders, right? And who's managing the company? It is the board of directors. Theek hai? Now, the people who are managing the show, they are only going to get a fixed sum of money. They are only going to get a salary. They are all salaried employees. So, agar company ko profit zyada hota hai ya fayda zyada hota hai, to fayda kiska ho raha hai? Owners ka. But people who are running the show, right, they are not going to be benefited that much, right? So there is no direct link between ki aap kitna zyada company ko grow kara rahe ho aur aapko uska kitna fayda ho pa raha hai. So there is a impersonal work environment. There is no personal touch to it. Theek hai? That jitna kaam matlab for the amount of fee that they are getting, for the amount of, there is no direct motivation for them, you know, ki agar hum company ko aur zyada, you know, heights pe pahunchayenge to hamari salary usse, definitely there's going to be a jump in their salary and all, right? But a huge part of the profit, the huge part of the profit is going to go into the pockets of the shareholders. Then comes delay in decision making. Now, in a company form of organization, there are different levels in an organization. There is a top level management, there is middle level management, and then there is a lower level of management, right? So when a decision has to be taken, when a decision has to be taken, right, a lot of people have to be consulted. A lot of opinion of different departments have to be taken, right? Different approvals and all have to be taken, right? So it decision making becomes a lengthy process, and it takes a lot of time to arrive at a final decision. Then there is an oligarchic management. Now, although we say because the shareholders are spread over a wide geographical area and therefore they elect their representatives in the form of board of directors, right? But what it actually happens is that these board of directors, they use all kind of means to get themselves re-elected, right? They get to get themselves re-elected. So basically, it is not the interest of the shareholders which has been, you know, given importance, but therefore their personal gains, they always try to be re-elected as board of directors. Then conflict of interest. There are different interest groups that the company has to cater to, right? That a business has to cater to, or that a company has to cater to. It is the government, it is the shareholders, right? It is investors, suppliers, fine. Now, customers would want to get the best quality product at the lowest possible price, right? Best quality product at the lowest possible price. But the shareholders, they want the higher rate of return on their investment. They want higher return on investment. Now, both the interest groups, they have their own expectations from the company. But if you look at the two expectations, right, they go against one another. They go against one another. If I am going to sell the products at the lowest possible price, then how am I going to give a higher rate of return to my investors? Right? So there can be conflict of interest that has to be taken care of.